To stop climate change, Sweden has committed to achieve net zero emissions by 2045 and net negative emissions after that, according to its climate law. Net zero means that total emissions in Sweden will have to be equal to what is removed by ecosystems or by technology. However, in total, real emissions will have to be reduced by 85% to meet the target. There are a number of technologies. For instance, you could plant trees to increase the amount of carbon that you sequester, that you absorb from the atmosphere. There's also a technology called BECCS, Bioenergy with Carbon Capture and Storage, where the idea is that you grow bioenergy crops and then you use those crops in a power plant, in a bioenergy plant, and the emissions from that plant you capture and then you store the carbon underground. And you could also absorb emissions directly from the air with a technology called direct air capture. However, there are uncertainties and concerns associated with all of these technologies and approaches to remove carbon. Well, firstly, the question is, will these initiatives be implemented in a just way? There are a lot of previous experiences with carbon removal, especially in the global south, that show that these projects are not always implemented in a way that benefit local communities, and that even might have negative consequences. There are quite a lot of examples of projects where people lose their land, for example, to these climate change solutions. Secondly, it's not at all clear that these technologies are viable at the scale that they are assumed. They don't currently exist in the real world, they only exist in models. As these models assume that you would need to have up to a third of the arable land on the planet to plant, for example, bioenergy crops to use in a technology like BECCS. So because of this, it's not at all clear that you could do this in a way that would not jeopardize or endanger biodiversity objectives or food production, for example. There's also the question of economic viability. To be able to do this, you would probably need public support, public funding from the government. There's no obvious business case to remove carbon from the atmosphere and store it underground. And so far, of course, governments have been very unwilling to commit the kind of financial resources that are necessary to solve climate change. So it's difficult to see how this would be different. Finally, the question is, what are we not doing instead? I'm afraid that the promise of these technologies makes us less likely to radically reduce our emissions. If negative emissions provide a false sense of security about a technological promise on the horizon, it could distract us from the more near-term solutions that we need to implement right now.